In the world of getting things done, there are kids, like Josh Smith.
I'm 13, so I can cook like eggs, bacon, toast.
He's an active seventh grader at Summit Middle School in Frisco.
You gotta be like mischievous.
Like many school districts around Colorado, Summit County has a problem.
When I began school, it was kind of hard. Every day I'd have to text or call my mom and say, like, should I ride the bus today? Will they allow me to ride the bus today?
Not enough bus drivers means not enough seats. While sitting down to eat with his dad, Jason, Josh said something intriguing.
One night around dinner, Josh just said, hey, Dad, would you mind if I kayak to school? And some kids, if they say that, you just kind of laugh it off and say, yeah, sure, no problem. But I knew if he asked it, he was probably planning on doing it, and I needed to be careful in my response.
So when the conditions are right, Josh gets up early.
Bye, Mom.
To give up his seat on the school bus.
I would decide to just kayak to school because I always want to do something cool that I'll remember for my whole life, and I will remember this for my whole life.
I can remember finally pushing him off into the reservoir thinking, what have I just done?
Josh sets out on Dillon Reservoir.
Just throw my bag in the front, hope I don't capsize and get to school.
The route is 2 miles long.
I really like how every time I do it, the sun rises, like when I'm in the middle of the lake, and the whole lake is really smooth and like glass.
The view is strictly Colorado.
I just think it's really pretty and stuff, and I think it's worth it.
The danger is real, but Dad is always watching.
I try and follow him just because, you know, part of my job as Dad is to protect him and keep him from doing stupid stuff or getting in trouble.
If Dad's always there.
Well, I always check my time. I always keep an eye on the time.
Why not just drive Josh to school?
When my now 13-year-old boy approaches me and wants to do something out of his comfort zone, wants to stretch himself a little bit, wants to do something different, something unique, something that's a challenge, I gotta back that up.
Though this wasn't the original plan, Josh's kayak commute is having an unintended effect.
We like called the Summit Daily and they're like, oh my gosh, yeah, we're putting you in the newspaper. And then like all of these news channels wanted me and everything. And now if like New York wanted to have me go there, I'd be like, yeah, okay.
He is creating a national awareness of the worker shortage in schools.
I've got a client in Detroit, Michigan who called me and said, is your son's name Josh? We heard about him on the radio this morning.
And I think he's just an example of the kind of thinking that's in this community. You know, he reflects our community.
Roy Crawford is superintendent of Summit County Schools. He hopes added interest can lead to solutions for a small district that had to cut nearly half of its bus runs.
People don't travel here for that kind of work. So I think because of our isolation and because of our remoteness, it really limits the pool more than it might in more populous parts of the state.
If it gives them some more attention, shines a light on them, then we think it's a positive.
A kayak trip reaching places Josh never imagined.
I think that everyone is just intrigued by it because they've never heard anything like it.
Though the weather over Lake Dillon is changing, Josh still plans to get it done.
When the lake freezes over and when it's too cold for me to do it, I'm going to cross country ski to the school. So I'm going to cross country ski across the lake.
With photojournalist Tom Cole.
I will tell you this, if he Nordic skis, I'll be skiing along with him.
Nelson Garcia, 9 News.